cover it himself, flirting with disaster there. He falls on it back at the 11-yard line. That may take a little momentum out of him.
I don't know. They've looked awfully good in this drive, and they've really put the LR defense. They're just up for grabs right now. The Fighting Christians have thrown the ball well, and with Clark back there. Folks, look at number 35, the tailback, how low he gets to the ground behind the fullback.
One thing for sure is they're not going to try a field goal if they don't convert on third down. They go to the money man, and Clark gets to about the 5-yard line. And I'm not sure. I don't think he's going to have enough for the Elon first down. It's going to be fourth down and about a yard for Elon with 2 minutes and 35 seconds to go in tonight's contest. Elon talking it over. Right, here's the ball game, Juju. Fourth and a yard at the LR5. The Bears have stopped them once down here. Can they do it again?
They stopped them twice. They blocked a field goal here in this half. Let's see what happens. Elon wants a timeout.
Let's keep it right here because with only 2:15 to go in the ball game, we had a 14-10 ball game at halftime, and let's recap the scoring for you here in tonight's second half. Elon had the first opportunity to score as they lined up for a field goal in Lenoir Rhyne territory, and the Bears blocked that field goal, took over at their own 10-yard line, and put together a textbook drive, perhaps their best drive of this season, 17 plays, 90 yards. It was a Laurendean pass to Jones that got the touchdown as the Bears took a 21-10 lead following the extra point of Dan Quinn with 14:55 to go in the football game. Elon came right back, helped with a 15-yard penalty against the Bears. They took over at their own 49 and then drove it down the field where Inge ran in for 4 yards. Mullen's extra point made it 21-17 with 11:28 to go in the contest. And now the Bears, after punting, saw Elon take over at their own 12-yard line. They've strung together this drive to where they have it now fourth down and a yard to go at the LR5.
The man with the headsets on there in your picture is Elon head coach Mackie Carden. He played here. He knows the system. He knows the tradition that Elon has. They have won NAIA championships, Jeff, in the 70s. They are one of the powers in NAIA football.
This is the 12th play of this possession for Elon. They give it to Clark, and I think he's got the first down at the 3-yard line. As Elon went to their money back, and behind the blocking of Kevin Campbell and David Emery, they've got the first down. They'll have first and goal to go from the LR 3-yard line.
You could have polled everybody in this stadium, and to a man they would have said, and to a woman, they're going to give it to number 35.
Well, now the Bears have their backs to the wall. We're down to 2 minutes to go in the game, and Elon threatening here to punch in the go-ahead touchdown. From the LR 3-yard line, they've got four cracks at it now. As Elon was in motion on the play, Marion jumped twice trying to get set, and that's going to cost them 5 valuable yards down there.
Well, it's an incomplete pass. What are the Bears going to do? They're going to force him 5 yards back, or they're going to take a down. It's either going to be second at the 3 or first at the 8.
I don't think they have an option because the motion penalty, the flag comes up as the play gets underway, and I would think they'll take the penalty here instead of the yardage. We'll see. They're going to give the Bears an option, however.
I'd take the yardage. That's too close for Clark to dive over for a touchdown.
So the 5-yard penalty puts it back out over the 5 at about the 8-yard line. So now they've got first down and goal to go from the 8-yard line. A minute 48 to go. And if Elon goes to the air, time for Marcus Wall to work his magic once again.
I don't know. Only 4 penalties now for the Fighting Christians in this football game. Under 2 minutes to go. You still give it to Clark, Jeff. He's got 4 downs here to make 8 yards.
Pair of wide outs to the top of your screen. They give it to Clark, makes a nice cut back, and he gets inside the 5 to the 3-yard line. That ball popped loose out of there, and LR's claiming they've got possession of it.
He fumbled the football.
There's Bob.
He got the football. It's a fumble.
And the Bears have recovered. The Bears have recovered.
Brian Foster, Jeff, came out of the pile. Clark fumbled it going around the right side. He got loose of it and tried to go forward. It was a fumble, and Brian Foster came up with it. The minute 35, 38 seconds to go, and hallelujah, Hickory.
For the second week in a row, something good happens for the Bears at the right time.
Well, let's hold our breath here for about a minute 38 seconds.
That was the 13th play of their drive, and it turned out to be an unlucky 13th play for Elon.
For now. How many timeouts does Elon have?
I think they have only one left. Lenoir Rhyne, with a minute and 38 seconds to go in the contest, has it at their own 4-yard line after the fumble recovery. Here's the handoff to Baldner, and Russ gets a couple of yards, but more importantly, the Bears have possession of the football with a minute 25. And I don't think Elon has but one, if they have any, timeouts left. As the Bears, Brian Foster, the weak side defensive end out of Forest City, the senior, comes up with a big fumble recovery. And the Bears are trying to hold on for dear life. We're down to a minute 5 to go as Larndean brings them up to the line of scrimmage. Pitching it back to Crawford, trying to get up some running room, and he's going to be first down yardage for the Bears over the 10 out to about the 15-yard line, and that is a Lenoir Rhyne first down. We're under a minute to go in the game.
Anybody know Don Meredith's favorite song?
Turn out the lights. The party's over. I can't sing it as well as Don.
I know that.
But I do remember the tune. 37 seconds. Elon apparently out of timeouts because they're not taking one. At the 14-yard line, the Bears have first down and 10 yards to go. Larndean gives it to Baldner, and he's hit right at the line. But now Elon will move in and take a timeout. And with 24 seconds to go in the contest, let's keep it right here because I think this will be nothing more than just trying to stop the clock. And the Bears are going to go 2-0 in the sack 8 for the first time ever. They're going to be in first place after tonight. And depending on what happens down at Newberry, they may be there all by themselves after the second week of conference play.
The city of Hickory and Catawba County has a team in first place in the South Atlantic Conference, and quite possibly, Jeff, by next week, a team in the top 10 in the NAIA. After last season, many people didn't know because the Bears didn't beat a team that had a winning record. Oh, yeah, they went 7-4, but the teams they lost to had better records. If they win this game tonight with 24 seconds left in this football game and Elon is out of timeouts, the Bears would have beaten the top two teams or one of the top two teams in the SAC 8, and they're 2-0. Well, man, oh, man, next week this place should be packed with
two
people.
Two of the four teams that they lost to last year are already out of the way. Presbyterian last week, and in 24 seconds, Elon tonight. As Elon cannot stop the clock, all the Bears have to do is snap it one time, fall on it, and it will be a 21-17 Lenoir Rhyne victory. Larndean will step back and fall on it. And let's listen to the LR faithful count it down. There's a flag, so that will stop play for just a moment.
John Perry on the field. Let's get a shot of him. He's at the 20-yard line.
John's a little upset. He thought Elon was a little physical on that play, and there's going to be a penalty coming up here against Elon. That's the only way they can stop the clock right now. Unsportsmanlike conduct against LR and against Elon. They're going to call it both ways.
But it stops the clock, and that's what Elon wanted.
Well, 18 seconds to go, and the only way they can stop the clock is with a penalty, but if they keep doing that with penalties, the Bears are going to end up with a first down out of it. So,
Jeff, they're going to try to probably stop it here, try to get another penalty. It's third down and 10.
They wound the clock. LR does not have to snap the football. You can start celebrating at College Field.
Go crazy, folks.
Get a shot of John Perry and the Bears. They are 2-0 in the sack 8 for 1988. It is over. The Bears have won it. A Brian Foster fumble recovery at the Bear 4-yard line preserves a victory over Elon here tonight. And you see John Perry and the Bears in their celebration here. A 21-17 Lenoir Rhyne victory over Elon here tonight.
It's been a long time, folks, since Lenoir Rhyne has been in first place in the SAC 8. And this is the first time they've ever, as you see in your screen, gone 2-0 in the SAC 8. This team's in first place. You ought to come out and see them next week. Gardner Webb's in town. The Bulldogs, it's homecoming, and we'll have it right here on cable TV. Coming up in the next few moments, we're going to interview John Perry, name our Centel player of the game, and join in the celebration as the Bears beat Elon 21-17. We'll do all of that after this on the Lenoir Rhyne College Cable Sports Network.
The years go by, the family grows, and things change almost before you know it. That's why the State Farm Family Insurance Checkup is there, to help you keep up with all those changes. A State Farm agent will show you just where you stand on your life, health, home, and car insurance. The advice is free, and the decisions are yours.
Your State Farm agents in Hickory are William S. Barkley, 4th Street Southwest, Ron H. Whaley on Highway 127 North, and Bobby Phillips on Springs Road.
What's located near Hickory's three major highways has 3,000 square feet of meeting and banquet space and provides dining and entertainment nightly. There's no need to guess. When it comes to the area's most complete entertainment and business facility, it has to be Hickory's Ramada Inn. 108 guest accommodations are just the start of what we have to offer. The Ramada Inn's banquet rooms can satisfy 300 or 300, plus live entertainment nightly at Khaki's Lounge. So don't guess. Call on the professionals at Ramada Inn, your business and entertainment connection.
Tired of your old business phone system? Then focus in on some really hot property, the Panther series from Trillium. It doesn't matter how small your business is, because Panther will grow with you from 3 to 20 lines. You'll get unsurpassed reliability, a variety of useful features, and you'll have the security of getting your business phone system from people who've been in the phone business for over 50 years. Centel. With their exclusive rental option, you won't worry about maintenance, depreciation, or a big cash outlay. So hang up on phone worries. Call Centel and say Trillium.
Every Marvin window is crafted by hand to ensure it fits exactly the way you want it to. Because at Marvin, we believe a beautiful wood window can add more than light to a room. It can add life.
Supplying all your building needs.
The celebration continuing here at College Field tonight is the Bears, for the first time since Juju Phillips wore number 19, have beat Elon in a football game that goes all the way back to 1982 when Elon came into College Field. And on that particular night, they were ranked number one in the NAIA, and the Bears upset them. And I guarantee you it's upsetting to Elon to lose again tonight.
This 1988 team is a much better team than 1982. And there you see John Perry telling his players, "Oh yeah, fellas, we're 2-0, but we got a little bit of breaks tonight late in the football game, but we took advantage of it." And this football team right now has won 11 out of its last 16 games, dating over the last couple of seasons. And John Perry has turned the LR football program back on its feet over the last couple of years. And tonight, what a thrilling football game. It came down to one play again, Jeff, against Guilford, against Presbyterian, and again here on the big play by Foster. Man, we've gone down to the last, 2 minutes in three football games this year.
Three out of five have gone down to the last series of the football game. But isn't it nice to know that the Bears are now 2-0 in the SAC 8? Catawba lost today. They fall to 1-1. Elon's loss tonight puts them at 1-1. We don't know about Newberry and Mars Hill, but if Newberry wins that game, they'll be tied with the Bears at 2-0 in first place in the SAC 8. And that comes up, we'll know that a little bit later on tonight. They're playing in Newberry tonight. Wingett and Gardner-Webb playing. We don't know the result of that, but that's a non-conference game. As Lenoir Rhyne wins it tonight, 21-17, after leading 14-10 at the half, the Bears win it. We'll come back and name our Centel player of the game, and Cheryl Sigmund will have John Perry and perhaps our player of the game on the sidelines for some comments when we come back. You're watching Lenoir Rhyne on Catawba Valley Cable TV.
What's located near Hickory's three major highways has 3,000 square feet of meeting and banquet space and provides dining and entertainment nightly. There's no need to guess. When it comes to the area's most complete entertainment and business facility, it has to be Hickory's Ramada Inn. 108 guest accommodations are just the start of what we have to offer. The Ramada Inn's banquet rooms can satisfy 300 or 300, plus live entertainment nightly at Khaki's Lounge. So don't guess. Call on the professionals at Ramada Inn, your business and entertainment connection.
Yeah. Killian's Hardware, located on Springs Road, is positively the most complete hardware you'll find anywhere. Built on a solid reputation of good old-fashioned service on everything they sell.
Now you can save up to 25% on Lawn Boy mowers. For over 30 years, the versatile Lawn Boy has been the choice mower for beautiful lawns like yours. Get them on sale now.
Killian's Hardware will try and beat any dealer's advertised price. And we offer free layaway.
Just for fun, bowling for the action when the weekend comes. Shake 'em up,
shake 'em up.
It's the weekend last when the lanes are fast.
Shake 'em up.
Forget the wintertime blues. Here's wintertime news. Bowling leagues are now forming. Shake 'em up.
Shake 'em up. To a day or night, bowling's out of sight. Shake 'em up.
Sign up now for fall winter leagues at Twin City Lanes, Highway 321, Newton.
Team, want it recovered to show.
Back here at College Field in Hickory, the Bears still celebrating a 21-17 victory over Elon. Cheryl Sigmund is standing by with Brian Foster, the Bear who recovered the fumble here tonight. Let's switch down to her at this time.
Standing here with Brian Foster, the man who recovered that fumble down there in the end zone territory, saving a touchdown. Brian, talk about the defensive effort tonight. It was exceptional inside the 10-yard line.
Well, we got lucky at the right time. On the last play of the fumble, we had an outside blitz on. Guy took a good lick, dropped the ball, and I just happened to be in the right place at the right time.
How do you feel about tonight's game overall?
Feel great. First time we ever beat Elon, feels real good.
Real Congratulations. Good. Thanks a lot,
Thank
Brian. Brian Foster, up to you, Juju. Jeff?
Okay, Cheryl's also got Tommy Larndean standing by. Tommy Larndean is tonight's Centel Player of the Game, the Lenoir Rhyne quarterback, the transfer from Appalachian from Oak Ridge, Tennessee. 13 of 23 on the night, 197 yards and two touchdowns. And let's switch back to Cheryl with Tommy Larndean, our Centel Player of the Game.
Okay, I'm standing here with the Centel Player of the Game quarterback, Tommy Larndean. Tommy, first of all, congratulations to you, but talk a little bit about a defensive effort tonight. It was exceptional.
Our defense, I think every game, they just get better and better. And this game, I owe it to them. They saved me twice, I think. I took the sack there on our last drive. I should have got rid of the ball. They're doing a great job. They keep getting better and better.
Did you feel a lot of pressure back there tonight?
No, I really didn't. Offensive line did a great job. I think as well as defense, offensive line is getting better and better also. They're giving me a lot of time. They're doing great.
Okay, you beat Presbyterian College last week, Elon this week. Y'all are surprising some people, don't you think?
Well, I think so. You know, over the years here, I haven't had too good of records. You know, last year 7-4. And I think last year's record, 7-4, put us on momentum for this season. And we're really carrying over and doing well.
Looking forward to playing Gardner-Webb next week?
Oh, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Congratulations. Thanks a lot,
Thanks
Tommy.
A lot.
Okay, that's Tommy Larndean, Centel Player of the Game.
Okay, Cheryl. Thanks very much. We'll run John Perry over there to her in just a minute. John's standing in the wings next to her. We'll get him over there with Cheryl in just a moment. But Tommy Larndean, our Centel Player of the Game. And Juju, he's put stats up like that all season. But tonight, those two touchdown passes at critical times really helped the Bears come through here in the clutch as they pull out a 21-17 victory over Elon here tonight. John Perry is standing by with Cheryl Sigmund, the Bears coach, and it's going to be a happy conversation, I'm sure. Let's go back to Cheryl.
Coach Perry, great effort tonight. Give me your impressions of the second half.
Just, you know, fantastic. We had some great drives offensively and didn't get points. And, you know, we know what Elon's capable of. And after that one score, and they take the ball and boom, 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 and score. And then they get it back. And, you know, we're thinking exactly what happened against Carson Newman last week. They marched methodically down there. But our guys are just fighting and fighting. And they just believe, and if they keep playing, something good's going to happen. And it did.
I've said it again and again. We talked to Tommy and Brian about the defensive effort tonight. Tell me about it.
Great effort. Everybody's playing so hard. And, you know, that is a great offensive football team that we played tonight. And they got a lot of yards. But basically, we made them go a long way to get them. And, you know, we kept saying they had run an awful lot of plays without something bad happening. And the law of averages is going to catch them. And, you know, it did, along with some hard hitting and scrapping. Nobody gave up out there tonight.
Yeah. The surprising thing, I think, was that Dwayne Clark, the All-American, didn't do as much damage as Dixon did, the player who broke it open twice for long run.
Well, Dixon, you know, honestly, has got more speed than Clark. He's not as quite as power runner, but they run a little different plays when he's in there, but they're both great backs.
Looking forward to Gardner-Webb next
great.
Week.
Be a big one.
Okay,
fine.
Congratulations. Okay, Coach John Perry, back up to you, Juju and Jeff.
Okay, Cheryl, and she's doing a great job down there on the sidelines tonight. We run people after people over to her, and she can just come back with the important questions that our fans want to know about this Bear victory. We'll come back with the statistics and wrap up our broadcast from College Field tonight. Once again, the Bears a winner, 21-17. You're watching Lenoir Rhyne on Catawba Valley Cable TV.
The Sharp SF9500 duplicator not only copies 50 pages a minute, it zooms to reduce and enlarge, has enormous paper capacity, it even copies in four colors. And it's so economical that for the price you'd pay for some console copiers, you can get the Sharp 9500 and a duplicate.
Those folks up the road have a good car insurance agent, and they told their neighbors. These folks told their neighbors that same agent was good for life and health insurance, too. And this family recommended the same agent to insure their neighbor's home. Why do so many people end up buying all their insurance from a State Farm agent? Ask a neighbor.
State Farm is there.
Your State Farm agents in Hickory are William S. Barkley, 4th Street Southwest, Ron H. Whaley on Highway 127 North, and Bobby Phillips on Springs Road.
If you're considering buying new wood windows for your home, you should know that very few reach the quality of a Marvin double-hung window. Compared to the leading brand, a Marvin has the easy-tilt sash for easy cleaning, is more energy efficient, and comes in nearly three times the number of standard sizes. In fact, the only place a Marvin window can't beat the other window is on price. And we just dropped that. Marvin Windows. Compare the features, compare the price.
Supplying all your building needs.
Well, the Bears' television record runs to 3-0, Julius, as we have a 21-17 victory here tonight. Let's take a look at the statistics on tonight's ball game, and you run down through them.
Rushing yardage tonight, Elon finished with 342 yards rushing. The Bears only 157. As you see it, boy, Elon really piled up the yardage, but so did the Bears. Passing tonight, Tommy Lorndine, you see 197 yards passing. It got picture-perfect protection from that young offensive line. They put some pressure on, Elon did a couple of times, but for the most part, Tommy had all day to throw the football. First downs, pretty even, as Elon finished with 20. 449 yards of total offense by the Fighting Christians, but they had a touchdown called back on an interception late in the first half as the Bears got an interception, then late in the game on the fumble here. So Elon moved the football up and down the field, but as John Perry said, if you force a team to go 80, 90 yards every series, sooner or later, something bad is going to happen, and it did tonight. But you see the most critical statistic, I believe, tonight, Jeff, in the last 2 weeks, it has been that. Third down conversions. The Bears last week, what, were 7 of 11? 10 of 17 last week. This week, 7 of 11. Turnovers, Elon finishes with 3, the Bears 2, and Tommy Lorndine, our Centel player of the game, for his outstanding effort tonight. But I think you can probably give the Centel player of the game to a lot of different players. Everyone contributed tonight, and that's what it takes when you're a team in first place.
Well, you know, Elon, they got yardage all over the place here tonight. You saw it there on the screen, 449 yards in total offense. Between the 20s, the Bears had a hard time stopping them tonight. But when it got down to crunch time, Elon on a 4th-and-1 at the LR-10 couldn't convert. Elon, a little bit later on, got in LR territory after taking over on a fumble recovery at the 21, saw Mungro intercept the pass and stop Elon's possession. Again, they got a good field position as they got deep in Lenoir Rhyne territory, and the Bears block a field goal. And then the last possession of the game, Elon threatening late in the game. They fumble the football, then Brian Foster makes the recovery. The Bears gave yardage all over the field, but when they got inside the 20, the defense got tough.
And that's what enabled Lenoir Rhyne to sneak out a win. They're second in the SAC 8. They're 21-17. And back here next Saturday afternoon between the bricks against the Bulldogs from Gardner-Webb College. It's homecoming. It should be a good crowd, and they're going to welcome in a team that's in first place no matter what happens in the rest of the SAC 8 tonight. The Bears of Lenoir Rhyne College are in first place in the South Atlantic Conference and moving up in the national standings. They'll back home next Saturday.
Look forward to being here for the broadcast at 2 o'clock. Is the kickoff time. We go on the air at 1:45 next Saturday afternoon. Hope you'll join us here at College Field as the Bears will host Gardner-Webb for Homecoming 88. Again, tonight's final score, Lenoir Rhyne 21, Gardner-Webb 17.
That'll wrap it up for tonight for our entire broadcast crew, our production staff as well, who's done a fine job this evening. Everybody up in the booth, my broadcast partner Jeff joins, and our statistician tonight, Frank Huffman, and Cheryl Sigmund down along the sideline in her first debut tonight did an outstanding job for everybody at Cable TV. Until next week, Saturday afternoon at 1:45, I'm Juju Phillips. So long, everyone. This is the Lenoir Rhyne College Cable Sports Network.
It's all behind me. remember. Even if it takes a million years. The song is over. The song is over. Such a long time. Pure and easy. Made so free like a breath rippling by.
For rock and roll. 95.7 WXRC Hickory, The Rock.